In this video, we will discuss why there are different igneous rocks. There are different sources for these igneous rocks. For example, the mantle is mostly composed of mafic material, and as magma comes up at mid-ocean ridges, it produces basalt and gabbro. In contrast, the crust is mostly composed of granite. There's something called magmatic differentiation, which is very important in forming different types of igneous rocks. For example, assume a magma is composed of 50% mafic minerals and 50% felsic minerals. It would be called a diorite or an andesite. However, recall that when we discussed formation of mafic and felsic minerals, it's the mafic minerals that form first. Assume that mafic minerals form first from that magma, and they settle out. They will produce perhaps a gabbro. But what's going to happen? The remaining liquid will form a granite, which is composed mostly of felsic minerals because those minerals form at lower temperatures. Now we'll discuss how igneous rocks are related to plate tectonics. We've already mentioned some of these points. For example, the oceans. At mid-ocean ridges, you produce basalt at divergent plate boundaries. Granites form when continents collide. That causes continental rock to heat up. You melt continental rock, you melt granite, you produce granite. What happens at subduction zones? Well, you have basalt flowing underneath the granite continent, and what's going to happen? You will melt some of that basalt, it will rise up, and it will produce a rock that's half felsic and half mafic. It's called an andesite, and you get volcanoes above subduction zones.